Welcome back, barcoders. Today, we're going to explore the efficient self-checking fonts from IDAutomation. You may be asking, what does self-checking mean? Self-checking fonts simplify integration by eliminating manual check digit calculations. Simply put, we'll need to surround the data with a start and stop character. There's a variety of options we can choose from. Which fonts provided by IDAutomation are self-checking and thus require no additional encoder? That would be the code 39 and Codabar. Code 39 can utilize the asterisks, the exclamation marks, and parentheses. Codabar, while it can use parentheses, its other start and stop characters are A, B, C, or D. Now, let's make some barcodes in Excel. From a blank workbook, I've added some data that will transform into scannable code 39 barcodes. We'll start with the asterisks. Select the cell where you want the barcode to appear. Then in the formula bar, enter an equal sign, quotation mark, asterisk, quotation mark, and ampersand followed by the cell you want to transform, A2 in this case. Next, add another ampersand, quotation mark, asterisk, and a final quotation mark. Press enter, and the data is surrounded by two asterisks. To finalize the barcode, apply the IDAutomation Human Readable Code 39 font. Once applied, we'll have a scannable barcode. Next, let's replace the asterisks in the formula with parentheses. By doing so, we see the asterisks are removed in the human-readable text below the barcode. Finally, let's cover the exclamation mark. Using exclamation marks, we'll add the asterisks back into the human text below. So a quick reminder, if you don't want them in the readable text below the barcode, always use parentheses. Voila! Now you understand how to use self-checking fonts. To quickly apply the formula to multiple cells, select the bottom right corner of the initial barcode cell, then drag the fill handle down to extend the formula across the desired range. This automatically generates a barcode for each corresponding data entry. For a quick code of our demo, I'll open up a new sheet and add a place for my data and my barcode. I'll enter in some data and we'll use the same formula we just saw in our code 39 example. We won't cover all the start and stop characters here, but we'll explore the parentheses variation since code 39 and Codabar can both utilize them. Be sure the data meets the standards for Codabar and to use the corresponding barcode font, IDAutomation CB. Awesome. Now, to perform a mail merge with code 39, you'll find that using parentheses instead of asterisks can make things a lot smoother. Let's walk through the process. First, save your Excel file as a macro-enabled workbook. Then, open a blank Word document, go to the Mailings tab, and choose Start Mail Merge. We'll use letters. Next, click Select Recipients and find the macro-enabled workbook you just saved. Select the worksheet you want and hit OK. Then go to Insert Merge Fields to add your data and barcode. Preview your page, and you'll see your data surrounded by parentheses. Just like in Excel, apply the code 39 font to your barcode, and above to the right, you'll be able to flip through all the barcodes with ease. See? That wasn't so painful after all. Before we wrap up, let me show you how to handle extended code 39 in Excel. Suppose you want to encode a quotation mark in your barcode. As you might notice, directly entering the quotation mark results in an unscannable barcode. But there's a simple solution. Using the extended code 39 ASCII character table, replace the quotation mark in your data with slash B. This substitution allows you to encode the quotation mark correctly in the barcode. For additional extended characters, check out the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, remember, we are your source for quality symbology.